Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Erica and I make videos all about making and selling candles. If you guys are interested in checking out what my Etsy shop looks like, or if you wanna see any of my merch designs, go ahead and check out the first links in the description box below. Today's video is really exciting because I'm going to be revealing to all of you my top 10 best sellers and what fragrances I use with them. So I will be showing you guys exactly where I get them, what the fragrance is. So if you guys wanna go out and get them, you're more than welcome to. We are all free to use whatever fragrances we want to. A couple of these, actually, I think only one of these are an actual blend, and I will kind of get into that. So technically there's 11 bottles here, but it's a total of 10 fragrances. So let's go ahead and get right into the video. The first one is Aztec Leaves, and this is called Leaves BBW Type. So whenever you guys see type on it, it just means that it's kind of a dupe for the Bath & Body Works scent. So this one in my line is called Autumn Air, and I have it in my fall line. So it's a nice, just really nice fall scent. It's a crisp kind of apple and nectar and cinnamon type of scent. It's really, really nice. I've always really liked this scent. It's kind of an OG scent for me because I've been using it since the very beginning of me making candles. I have an old photo of what the candle looked like when I was trying to make my candles in the matte black jars when I first started making them. And my sister actually has that candle still. I believe she's almost out of it, so she's gonna need another one soon. It's taken her a long time to burn it. But yeah, this one is definitely a bestseller for me. This next scent is called White Sage and Lavender by Candle Science. And this is such a nice take on lavender that's not just a straight lavender. So the more earthy type of notes in it, the sage, and there's probably more earthy notes in it as well, but it just kind of blends together really nicely with the lavender. So again, it's not kind of that just overpowering lavender smell. Again, it's not one of my favorites, but it's a really good seller. So I always sell out of this one when I put it up in my shop. I have it under the name Vinyasa Flow, so that's kind of what I chose to name it. But this one is a really nice seller, and a lot of people that order it and buy it say that it's just such a nice, unique type of lavender scent, and it's not overpowering, but it's just kind of a really calming scent. This next scent I've talked about before, it is called Fruit Loops by The Flaming Candle. This scent, you guys, I have always sold out of this scent. It's my best friend's favorite scent, so even if nobody else in the world wanted it, I would still buy more bottles just to make candles for her. But it is such a bestseller, and it's that Fruit Loops kind of fruity pebbles type cereal smell. I believe the notes on it is like a lemon, sandalwood, and vanilla. It just goes so well together, and it just has such a nice, unique, and nostalgic type of scent. So I do have it within my nostalgia collection under the name Saturday Morning Cartoons, and it's just such a good seller. So many people love this one, and they get so excited when they smell it because it kind of triggers something in your head of, I know what that scent is. And not a lot of times people know exactly what it is, but they know that they're connected with it somehow. But it is kind of that like cereal, just kind of fruity scent. But I love this one. I love making this one. I've always really liked this one. I can never get enough of it. I can never get sick of it. And that's really hard to do sometimes with fragrance oils. If you guys know and you work with them a lot, sometimes even your favorite ones from the beginning, you can kind of stop liking it. But this one, I always love this one. This next one is called Sugar Cookie Royale, or Royal, I think it's Royale, and it's by The Flaming Candle. And this one has been such a huge hit with my Christmas scents, my winter line that I have. And this one I have under the name Christmas Cookie, and it is just a very kind of just a straight up vanilla icing, vanilla sugar cookie type of scent. So many people love this one when they get it. It's not like that fake kind of, you know, really gross scent where you go into like any random store that has $5 candles and it's a vanilla scent or that French vanilla scent. It doesn't smell like that at all. It's just a very nice, just kind of authentic vanilla cookie type of scent. And I really love this one. I took a gamble on it. I ordered 2 16-ounce bottles without ever testing it. I don't recommend it, but you guys can't say that you've never done that before either. And I took a gamble with it. It had such good reviews. I'm so glad I did because it was the perfect addition to my winter collection. So glad I got it and so many people love it. I gotta say, this is probably my best seller out of my winter collection. So I'm so happy that I took a chance on this one because everybody loves this one. This next scent is called Honeysuckle Jasmine by Candle Science, and I have such a love-hate relationship with this scent. It is, without a doubt, one of my absolute best sellers that I think I have in general. None of these are in order. I don't have anything in order from the best absolute seller. These are just all good in general. But this one, you guys, for some reason, everybody loves this scent so much. And to be honest, when I first smelled it, I really liked it too. But after you smell it, like, 1700 times and it's just like wafting around in your apartment, it just is so overpowering. And now I absolutely hate this one, but I'm gonna keep it forever because so many people love it. And it's in my shop under the name After the Rain, which I do actually really like that name, and it does work really well with this scent. But a lot of people really like this scent. It's just a nice kind of clean floral scent. And yeah, I don't know what else to say about it. If you guys have never tried it, definitely give it a try. So many people really love this scent, and I am glad that I added it to my shop because I know that so many people have other different senses than I do. But again, it's just one of those scents that you make, you get over it because you have to smell it, and you move on because people love it. Okay, this next one is again by The Flaming Candle, and it's called Autumn Flannel. So if you guys have ever been on The Flaming Candle, they have like a trillion different fragrance oils, and I believe they have one called just Flannel and probably one just called Autumn. But this Autumn Flannel one is so unique. It's more of a masculine type of smoky scent, and I believe the notes I have are smoky woods, musk, and almond. And this actually is just such like a nice scent. It's very unique, but it is very kind of fall and autumn. It works really well in kind of that season. Also, I have just an 8-ounce right here because when I ordered it, they sent me 2 8-ounce bottles, even though I ordered 16. So that's why this bottle is a little bit smaller. But this is very, very popular. A lot of people really like this one. I usually always sell out of it whenever I have it up in my shop. So a lot of people really like this one, especially if you tend to lean more towards kind of that masculine type of smoky, musky scents. So yeah, this one definitely really popular. So the next scent is called The DJ in my shop, and it is a blend of both of these fragrance oils. I do a 50-50 blend, and I do Aztec's Tobacco and California Candle Supplies Mahogany Teakwood. This scent is probably one of my favorite scents of all time. I love Mahogany Teakwood so much. It's just such a nice masculine, just a very good kind of like a cologne type of scent, but not super overpowering. And the blend of these two together just works really well. I love the way that this one comes out. It's probably one of my personal favorite scents, and I do like that I blend it together because, as you guys can see, I'm not as adventurous with blending things together. I really like the blends already that come in the bottles. So I really like that I was able to blend these together because it is kind of more of like a unique scent. But yeah, this one always does really well in my shop. And I haven't had too many of my scents from the Nostalgia collection up because it has been kind of more of the fall collection and the winter collection. But I am starting to make more of my Nostalgia collection scents, and I will be adding a lot more to my shop, especially come January. I'm gonna start adding more, and yeah, I'm just really excited to have it back up. So this is definitely a really good seller. The next scent is from The Flaming Candle. It's Coffee House. I've talked about this so much in my previous videos. This is such a bestseller. People love coffee scents. To me, it doesn't smell like really that much like coffee. It smells more of like a caramel frappuccino type of scent, but it's really nice. Kind of has that like vanilla caramel type of scent to it, and people absolutely love this one. I always sell out of it when I have this up in my shop, so I will keep this one. But yeah, I've had this one pretty much since the beginning. The next scent is by Candle Science and it's called Sea Minerals. So this one is kind of more of like that beachy type of scent. And in my shop, I have it under Trips to Nowhere. And I feel like people really like it. Probably with the name and the scent together, this one is really popular. And so many people have really, really left really good reviews for this scent. It's kind of like a linen, oak moss type of ozone sea salt type of scent. It's really nice. It's really unique and it's very kind of refreshing and calming and just kind of like a really nice beachy scent. This one has definitely been a really, really big seller of mine. So if you guys are looking for a nice beachy scent, definitely check this one out. And last but most certainly not least is Cashmere Plum from Candle Science. This is one of my all-time favorite scents. I absolutely love this one. I have it under Indigo Rain in my fall collection. And this always sells out when I have this scent up. So many people love this scent. It is such a high-end type of, almost like a luxury type of scent in my opinion. It's just such a nice scent. I believe it's black cherry, plum, and amber are the notes that I have on it. But it's so, so good. And I have so many people that have actually reached out to me, candle makers that are wondering what this scent is because it's just so good. And I wish that I could create a blend as good as this one. But if you guys have not checked this one out, definitely do so. I kind of wish that I would have saved this scent for like maybe a luxury line in the future just because I feel like it's that good. But it definitely was such a big hit for my fall collection. So if you guys have not, definitely check this scent out. And that is that, you guys. That is all of my best-selling scents, or at least my top 10 that I felt was worthy enough to bring up to you guys in today's video. I kind of tried to have more of a variety of fruity and sweet and beachy and, you know, masculine type of scents just so you guys can see kind of a variety. Because if it was up to me, I'd probably only have like fruity scents or masculine scents, probably the only ones in my collection. Because those are my favorites, but you gotta always think about the customer and what the majority of people are going to like. So I will leave a link to all of these fragrance oils so you guys can check it out in the description box below. If you guys like this video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up as well as subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And don't forget to follow me over on Instagram at memoryboxcandleco. And I will see you guys in the next video. Bye guys. Because if it was up to me, I'd probably only have fruity scents and masculine scents because those are my favorites. Dang it, there's somebody here.